16th March, and you can see the two shoots that have emerged. Those are the corn shoots, and so we have liftoff. Let's see how things go from here. So in the afternoon, some amount of sunlight is falling on the corn seedlings, and it will be slower growth than usual as compared to if it was in the full sun or on a terrace or in ground. But they will still grow and they will seek the sun and reach outside, and then after that the growth will accelerate. Last May 2020 update on the corn that I had sowed in my grow bag amendment video. So both the seeds germinated. You can see two plants here, and then in that video where I had sowed these seeds, I had showed you the corner grow bag where I had sowed Indian corn maybe 2 weeks prior to this one. So these plants have grown quite tall, and you can see the male flowers, flower trusses on top. There's no corn on the sides, and I just looked it up and it says that if it's too hot or if the nutrients are not enough, that happens in that situation. So what I'm thinking is there are two plants in each grow bag, 12 by 18, so I'm just going to remove the weaker plants from each grow bag and add more fertilizer. And one also needs regular watering, it seems. So instead of every second or third day, I am switching to alternate. So this one has come up all the way to the top of the grill, and I had this ribbon kind of to support another plant, so I've kind of given it some protection because we have breeze happening and I don't want the plant to topple. So for now it's secured by this ribbon, and once it grows taller, I'll just get it from here and let it go up. So then the frame of the grill will support the plant and hopefully it won't topple. So you can see how much difference 2 weeks of sowing makes because the sun is receding. Initially when the seedlings emerged, it took some time for the growth spurt to happen till they reached outside, and once they reach outside they get more sun. Inside the grow bag they were getting maybe just an hour or two, and now that they are outside they get around 4 hours of sun. So let's see. It's an experiment and we'll see how it goes, and if I get something then I'll definitely share. And let's see if the bees are happy with this, because this was the reason I sowed it in the first place, for the bees. Beehives are doing very well, both of them. This was the one that I had shifted, and initially I felt that it wasn't doing well, but it's recovered because you can see all the yellow flowers on the trees across. This is like the main foraging time. All the bees are hovering around. Because this one is strong, it's going to grow quick and shade out this one. So although this one is stronger than this one, this is the one that I'm going to be sacrificing in this grow bag. May 2020 corn update. You can see it's afternoon now, around 3:30 p.m. and the sun does not come inside the grills at all. It is only on the outside, and you can see now how planting at the edge helps. You can see that just the corn is getting sun. And over here, the third one is the Indian corn, where I had two plants growing for quite some time. So I think in some way that hampered the progress of this plant, although it's grown tall and reached the top, and the male flowers, they were there for quite some time. And now this is the first silk that I'm seeing over here. But I think the silk is late in its arrival because the male flowers have kind of dried up. I did try to move some flowers there and I put them here. I don't know how successful that will be. Now what this tells me is I should have sowed my corn seeds a little earlier than I did. So in the coming season, what I'll do is as soon as my tomato plants are done, I'll revamp the potting mix and sow the corn immediately. So that will give me a better chance. And let's see how these glass gem corns do. They're doing very well. One of them has reached on top over here. It's growing very well even on the outer side. I've been fertilizing regularly every 10 days and I've been watering every second day because I've read that corn loves a lot of water for it to thrive. See the corn here, it has recently started to develop these stilt roots. Now stilt roots are extra roots that the plant sends out for support. You can see here. So this is one of the pulled out roots. This part was under the soil. And look at all these stilt roots or support roots. They're here, they are here, they are also here. So this is the reason why corn is used as a windbreak. When you have a lot of wind and you want to protect your other plants from falling over, what people do is they plant two strong rows of corn plants and they get really tall and they break the wind and protect the plants that are there at the lower level. 13th June today and another corn update. You can see that all the three corns have grown tall and reached to the top of the grill, and all three got their tassels first, the male flowers first, and then started to show the silks. So in the one on the right hand side, the plant is also drying up, and though I tried to put some pollen on this corn here, I don't think anything will come out of it. But this corn, the glass gem corn, although it gave the tassels, this is also a male. Behind that it developed the silks too. So there are three here. So I'm hopeful that something will come out of this one. It's 20th June, I think. And this one is the Indian corn, the first one that set. I don't expect anything from this because we got this corn coming in much after the male flowers. I may get something, some corn kernels in this one because it looked like it pollinated successfully. Let's see. Let's look at this one. This is the biggest of the lot. And you can see the silks have dried up here also. Oh yes, yes. Wow. This This is so cool. Really awesome. One con, but I'm super thrilled. This one has just got a few kernels. Okay, so I'll try this next year. Some of you were waiting for this update, so here it is. Corn in, this was 2 hours sun in a 12 by 18 inch grow bag in a balcony. And I sowed this pretty late, so if this gets 2 months more, I'm sure I'll have more success next year. So after sorting through all of the corn, you can see I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 unformed ones, very small ones, and just one successful one. Next time I'll do better and let's see how it goes. I was told by a friend that one corn plant will give 2 or 3 or 4 maximum corns. If you have any tips and tricks and suggestions for me on which variety to grow and how to go about this, please feel free to leave a comment. And I hope you enjoyed this experiment. Thank you for watching. Happy growing, everyone.